Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Doomsday Last Survivors on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Doomsday Last Survivors and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Doomsday Last Survivors. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, the first thing to do is to open our favorite browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's go to this URL that I'm highlighting in green. Now, you are able to discover on the screen. There is no need to type the URL, simply because there's a link in the video description and as well in the first main comment. We arrived at this point on our website of Usitility, exactly where we have a nice meticulous explanation on the best way to download Doomsday Last Survivors on personal computer. We browse lower a bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on this link, we get to the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to enjoy the game Doomsday Last Survivors on the PC. As you can see from here we get some advantages of running that emulator. Then, we are ready to proceed to download the Doomsday Last Survivors by clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. Next step is clicking on the button. And the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is, this is the download. It is a file we have to execute. What we are going to do now is to launch the installer, okay, so we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow changes to the computer. We said yes. I reduce the internet browser to see the installer significantly better. The installer is uncomplicated, it consists of two choices, install, and setup path. I will make it clear what setup path really does. We simply just click on it. Therefore we realize that we get here the path where the emulator is going to be put in. If we would you like to modify this folder we must click on this, browse, option, and therefore we pick another directory and set up the emulator where we like. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. I click on back, so I just click install. Voila, the setup starts and it's going to move forward along with the download of all these megabytes that happens to be displayed on this computer screen. As you save it on your hard disk, it could be slightly more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate could go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, depending on your web access and according to the speed of the emulator servers. Now they are working extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this point, the emulator happens to be launched instantly. As you will notice, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar that will advance to the right when it has reached the end, the emulator is launched for the very first time. The fact is the emulator has been launched, here for the first time. Before we carry on, as you will notice, it has created two software icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is going to be the one we're focused on. Every time we desire to operate Doomsday Last Survivors on the PC, we twice click this specific software icon and launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. We should conduct the next step, that is a requirement, and which is to visit the Google Play Store. And we will just click on Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is started. There we need to sign in. At present once we are there, we are required to perform this next step that is definitely mandatory. So that we just click on, sign in. At this point it shows, checking info. It can from time to time get blocked in, checking info, and so it fails to move ahead. If that's the case, you may try to log in after a couple of hours and it may usually be repaired. At this point we can type in our email and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email as well as its corresponding password. For instance you could use the exact same email address you use currently in your YouTube account. Then I am going to type my info and I will come back after I have done it. That's all, info entered. And here is Google welcoming us and providing us their tools. We will say yes to them by simply pressing, I agree. After that, it makes possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You could let it selected and this will produce a backup of the files on that device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you do what you want. We click accept. Google Play Store is started by default and instantly. To set up the app, we would need to visit the emulator desktop for Android by clicking on that app icon designated green colored. Today that we are discovering the desktop of the Android emulator, we observe that we come with there the install video game option. We click on that button. Right here we come with the game. Why don't we press right here on the install choice that I am presenting now in green. Therefore it will launch the installation. At this point it should download and install the video game. It can take a while or perhaps it may just be very quick. This all relies on our own internet connection. This has as of now completed setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking that button that I'm showing in green, if you want to run Doomsday Last Survivors for the very first time. We're currently on the emulator desktop, then we're about to click the new Doomsday Last Survivors software icon that has been generated. This game app is launched for the first time on your device. Currently there we get it, I am able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should discuss the volume of this emulator. It's right here. We use the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we will not count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of this emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the fullest, we could switch on the large monitor, for which we have two options. That is actually the first one, we mouse click on this particular software icon which I am actually designating in green. Then the monitor is maximized, getting one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. Supposing that we need to appreciate the video game in full screen, we hit that app icon. And we'd by now be experiencing the video game in 100% screen function. To leave the complete screen mode, hit the F11 key. And therefore we would certainly by now end up being in regular display setting. At this moment I am on the way to reveal you the computer keyboard mapping that is really surprisingly appealing. That way we will likely be in a position to make use of the video game much more effortlessly. The first task is to click this app icon. And here you will have the ability to make the required adjustments. Let me let the default settings, but if you need to adjust that, you can easily achieve it without having problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is fully in our language. In some cases it happens that your emulator is presented in the incorrect language, such as, in Chinese. Then to place it in the right language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then there within additional configurations, we mouse click on the language drop down. We are able to opt for the language we need, English, Japanese, and so on. When the language is selected, we should save, the emulator will restart, as well as the game app, next time we start it, would also be in the picked language. At present, you can find another aspect that we will need to take into account, and it's that we will get a message from Gmail telling you that a new equipment has been associated with our own Google account. It will certainly question us if we're the ones who have associated with that device. Absolutely, we ought not worry, since the emulator is acting as an Android device. And then to determine which device is being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. So we browse here to the model option. And right here we notice that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for this training. I believe you enjoyed it, especially that you thought it was useful. In this case, allow it a nice like, subscribe, and any comments, requests or suggestions, let them in the comment field below. You may also leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I do live streams every once in a while, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click on any of these training videos which are usually appearing on the listing of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the next instructional videos. Bye.